This guy's always sleeping. Why? Do you have a pet that's sleeping all the time? Did you ever notice that your pet goes to sleep when the sun goes down? Does your pet have autoimmune disease and all these health issues? He doesn't either. I'm Dr. John Bartimus, and I'm putting the pieces together to help you live a life at Optimal. Recently, I've had a couple patients that have been doing really well in care take a step back. And when I'm quizzing them, what they're reporting is that they've had an increase in life stress and they've had a decrease in hours of sleep on average. And so the trend there is that they need to sleep more and they need to sleep more at the right times. Take Charlie, for example. Sun goes down, doesn't matter what we're doing, he's on this bed and he's sleeping. Humans used to be that way too, before artificial light came on the scene and devices and all of these other things. Since our society is so addicted to production, 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 work, 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 use every minute, squeeze every minute you can out of the day, our health has gone downhill as we've adopted those routines. And so just like I told those patients, I encourage you to get the sleep you need. And the best sleep, the most physically healing sleep, occurs before midnight. So you want to go to bed, you know, by 10 p.m. would be great. And the closer to sundown, the better. I know in typical human life now, that's not going to be possible, but it is possible to get to bed by 10. And so think about it. One of the ladies I was talking to recently has been going to bed on average at midnight and waking up at 5. So I was talking to her and I said, the biggest thing, more than any supplement or anything I could give you, the biggest thing you could do right now to change your health is go to bed at 10 o'clock every night. She's adding 2 more hours of sleep. Even if she wakes up at 5 a.m., that's a completely different picture. She wakes up rested and she's going to be ready for the day. Whatever work she would get done in that 2 hours, if she's waking up feeling unrested and starting the day behind the eight ball, was that work really worth it? Is her long-term health really worth whatever work she got done in those 2 hours? I highly doubt it. So if you're really struggling and you're grasping for straws, you're saying, I'm nailing my diet, I'm getting my workouts, I'm taking my supplements, really do a self-inventory of how is your sleep? Are you getting enough hours? And not only just enough hours, but the right hours. So 8 hours from midnight to 8 a.m. is not as good as 10 p.m. to 6 a.m. So really dive into your life and answer those questions. And if you find that you're not getting those quality hours, get as much sleep before midnight as possible or go to bed as early before midnight as possible and watch how that changes things.